sharing with you guys everything that I bought at IMADS Toronto. If you're not sure what IMADS is, it's basically the International Makeup Artistry Trade Show, which is a mouthful. And they come about once a year to Toronto, around November. And yeah, I go every year. This is my third year going. And yeah, it's just a good experience. But yeah, this is just all the shit that I bought. And I think I spent less this year than I ever have, which is awesome, which is good for me. But yeah, let's just get right into it. Every year that I go to IMADS, I always pick up some brushes because the brushes are so cheap and there are a lot of good brands there that do like really good quality brushes for a reasonable price. So I went to Delium Tools, and the bag that they give you just a plain paper black bag, but kind of went a little crazy. Ooh. I actually ended up going there twice because I bought a few and then I went back and bought some more. So the first brush I purchased was the Duet Fiber Powder, and this was $12, which is insane. And this is life. It feels so good. It feels so yeah, this was a really, really good buy, and I'm very, very pleased with that. The next brush I purchased was the 974 Tapered Powder Brush. And this is what it looks like. This one was $14, which is bizarre. It's smaller than the other one, but it was more expensive. But this, again, feels super soft. I think this will be great for contouring because I'm not a person who likes to go too, I guess, sculpted or defined with my contour. So for bronzer and like a light contour, this is going to be really, really... So next, I purchased the 994 Tapered Contour, and this one was $11. And this is what it looks like. This is perfect. Like, you can use this for contouring. You can use this for, what I purchased it for was to highlight under the eyes and the cheekbones, because it is just the perfect size. It's so soft. So it's not going to feel like scratchy underneath your eyes in that like sensitive area. And yeah, just nice. The next brush I purchased was their slanted contour brush. It's the 942, and this one was $7. Now, the rest of the brushes that I purchased were all from the line with the yellow ferrules, and the only difference with those brushes is the ferrules are a different color and they're cheaper. These ones, I guess, look more professional, so they cost a little bit more. And I mean, if you wanted to be a little bit more frugal, then you could just get them all in the yellow. I personally just like how my face brushes look when they're black, so it's kind of a little stupid vanity thing, but anyways. So this one is their slanted contour brush, and that's what it looks like. And yeah, it just feels really, really nice. And I have no clue. Small angled shader 765, and this one cost me $5, which is stupidly cheap. So that's what it looks like. I already have one of these, and I love it for the outer corner. It's really good for laying down product because it is a shader brush, so it's kind of on the flatter side. But if you look at it, I'm holding it awkwardly. If you look at it, it's not completely flat. It has a lot of fluffiness to it, so it's also really nice to blend out that outer corner. So I got two of these, the Shading Blender, which is the 773, and this one was $6. This looks just like the MAC 239, and that's my favorite shader brush, so I purchased this. Just looked really good to deposit color on the lid, and again, it's not like super flat, so it'll be nice to kind of blend out the edges if you're using a darker shade on your lid. And I think everyone always needs shader brushes. And then I purchased two of their 776 blending brushes, which were $5, and this looks just like the MAC 217. These work just as good. Honestly, I reach for these way more than I reach for my MAC ones for whatever reason. I don't know if it's just because they're cheaper, so I don't feel as bad using them up, but these are just using them up, their brushes, but you know what I mean, like dirtying them. But these are just like really, really good. They're just really multi-purpose, so I really dig it. And yeah, I purchased two of them. This is the brush roll I purchased, and I don't even know where I got it. Like, it was just some random stand I walked by, and I noticed that it was only $10, and it holds 20 brushes. And the thing I liked about this was it doesn't feel really cheap. Like, I've noticed, I've seen a lot online and like in person that were around the same price, and they just felt like shit. This just looks a little bit better quality, and again, you might think it's a little excessive to have a 20, like, I guess, what is this called? Slot brush roll to take with you to sleep over places, but I'm extra and I use a lot of brushes. So. And I also went to the Morphe booth and I ended up getting an entire palette of eyeshadows. So these eyeshadows were $3 each at the show. Ooh. Online they're $2 each, but you do obviously have to pay shipping. I live in Canada and they're based out of LA. So it still worked out to be a really, really good deal for me. And I believe the palette that I put them in was about $10 as well. So this is the 12 well palette, and I wanted to fill the entire thing. I'll just swatch a few of them for you just so you can get an idea. This one is probably my favorite one, and it's like a burnt orange, and that was an awkward spot, but look at, that's insane. Like, that is insanely pigmented. Some of them are a lot better than others, but that one was like probably the best one that I tried. Like, more neutrally kind of brown. This one isn't completely matte. If you look at it, it has like, it's a satin, I would say. So that's what that one looks like. Again, another warm brown shade, which is typical for me, but we'll swatch the red. Ooh, just dropping them. So they're actually pretty pigmented. So next we went to this booth that was selling Real Techniques brushes. I didn't purchase any of their actual brushes. My sister and my friends did, but I have quite a few of their brushes, and nothing there, they didn't have anything there that I don't already own or that I really, really needed. So I just ended up picking up their blending sponge. What is it called? Miracle Complexion Sponge. And I've yet to even, I don't even know what it feels like. I'm not gonna bother trying to get it. I only bought one thing from MAC because MAC had nothing. Like, they were sold out of everything I wanted, of course, which is really annoying. I really wanted Sora lip liner, but of course they were sold out. So I ended up purchasing Spice. And I wanted Spice for a while, so I was like, okay, might as well. It was my second choice, so. This is what Spice looks like. It's a neutral, I will swatch it for you. It's a neutral kind of browny pink. Really close to Sore, but a little bit more on the warmer side, a little bit browner, I think. Sore is more pink. We also went to the Jordan Cosmetics booth, which is, I guess, affiliated or, affiliated or something with Crown Brush. I only ended up picking up one lip liner from them, and this is in the shade Antique Rose. From videos that I've seen online, they usually do three eyeliners or lip liners for $9. This year they were only $7 each, so I only ended up picking up one. And this is the shade right there. And then we went to Nigel's Beauty Emporium. Now I feel like what I bought mostly from IMAX this year was eyelashes. There were 15 pairs for $20, so I kind of went off, and I'll just show you the ones that I got. I think I got quite a few doubles because they were sold out of a lot of them by the time that we went. So I got the 505s. That's just 747L, which are some of my favorites. These are probably the ones I always use in my videos when I do wear lashes. Like half lashes in the 307s. I got a pair of 42s, and then I got a pair of the 47s, which I don't know if I'll ever wear those. Those look crazy. I just got a bunch of individual lashes because these are just really easy for like casual wear. So I got the flare short black and the flare medium black. So I don't know if you can see the difference, but it's not a significant difference, but anyways. And then I also got this small mixing palette from Nigel's. I don't want to blind you, but this is just for, you know, when you put on your foundation, you like put it on the back of your hand. I don't want to do that. So I got a mixing palette. I think this will really come in handy. And then what I'm most excited about are my velour lashes. So I got four pairs. I got two of the Wing Woman pairs. And this is what they look like. They're just really, just beautiful. The other two that I purchased, the other two styles, were the Wispy Sweet Nothings, which were, they were ones that I wanted for a really long time. I think these are Jaclyn Hill's favorites, so if that means anything to you. But these are beautiful Wispy. And then I got Lashin City, which are pretty fucking out there. So that's what those look like. And yeah, I'm really, really happy. The last place that we stopped was the lip bar, and they give you this cute little card, which like that's fierce. So the first one I purchased was Whiskey Sour, which just looks like this. When I first saw it, it looks so much like Lime Crime Salem, but in a lipstick form. But it's actually a lot more orange swatched and on the lips, so that's what it looks
And
like. Just take in this packaging. Like, how cute is this packaging? So this is Sweet Shiraz, and it's just like a deep kind of purple, and again, so creamy, like feels so nice. That's it right there, obviously. And they don't have any offensive scent at all. They don't really smell like anything. And again, super cute packaging. The girls there were so nice, like so sweet. I was just like, wasn't planning on buying anything, and then she spoke to me, and I was like, take my money, like, you're so nice, like, I just like supporting smaller businesses like that, because it's nice, I don't know, it's just nice to see someone that's not like a massive corporation doing something that they love and doing it really well. So that's everything I purchased at IMATS Toronto. I'm definitely gonna go back again next year. I really want to go to LA, so hopefully that happens for me next year, but if not, I will be at IMATS Toronto next year. So let me know if you guys went and what you purchased. And yeah, give it a thumbs up if you liked the video. And please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos from me, because that would be really great. I'd really appreciate it. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.